Hello, my name is Marcin Iwaniec from Dragon's Daemon, and welcome to Hell Lava usage tutorial. In this video, I want to show you how to install Hell Lava asset in your scene. As you can see, I prepared two terrains. The left one is represented by a standard mesh. That mesh is split into 9 pieces, each with added mesh collider. The right ground is made using Jazz Unity terrain tool. So, with that said, let's create our first lava environment. First, we want to open Hell Lava Creator. Go to Game Object, select Create Other, and finally press Lava Environment. Lava Creator will be open so you can use it to generate your very unique lava environment. What you want to do at the beginning is to press New button. This will cause to create new empty object. Let's set it where we want our lava to begin and rename it, as every Hell Lava needs to have unique name so it can be later saved without any conflicts. I will rename it to Hell Lava Terrain and provide origin coordinates. Now, let's fill creator with basic data, that is height and width. Both our terrains have dimension 500×500, so we'll type that values into creator. Believe me or not, but basically that's it. You can generate your very own unique lava. But for the moment, let's pretend we mistake some values. For example, let's pretend we mistake height value. Creator will tell us about any error, so we don't have to worry about parameters that we are not sure what to provide. Also, in any case, we can just regenerate our mesh without any consequences. So, let's generate our mesh for real this time. Depending on your computer power and size of the generating mesh, it can take from 1 minute to 5. Generation process consists of 4 steps. Mesh generation, which is basically creating and fitting mesh vertices. Anti-aliasing vertices, which is smoothing any bumpiness in lava surface. Assigning triangles, which is connecting created in step 1 vertices into triangles. And finally step 4, where all no connected vertices are removed to clean final mesh. Taking the opportunity while the mesh is generating, there is a few more parameters that you can configure in Hell Lava Creator, like lava elevation, distance, or make advanced configuration. Each of that values will affect final Hell Lava surface mesh in different ways, and all of those parameters are covered in Hell Lava documentation that is available in two versions, for C# language and Unity JavaScript. Okay, the process is almost over. Let's see what we've got. Despite the difficult shape, it seems that surface generates pretty well. As you can see, lava is fit to the terrain, so mesh is optimized to be as light as possible. Also, other colliders are considered during generation process. That means there is no difference between meshes and terrains. It just have to be collider. Generated data was saved to this folder. Each Hell Lava contains two files. One with data provided in Creator, and one with a lava surface mesh. Alright, let's try to generate lava surface on the left, mesh-based terrain. First, we need to clear our Creator. Just set parent object to none. Now press New, like in the last time. Prepare created empty object, that is, rename it to unique name, and provide location of the lava origin point. Provide size of our lava. And finally, press generate button. Now, let's wait for the effects. As you can see, result is exactly the same. As I said previously, there is no difference for Hell Lava what is ground, as long as it have colliders on it. Surface is perfectly fit and elevated at shores, and also other colliders are considered during generation. So, let's see it in action. As you can see, lava flows in one direction, flowing around obstacles. You can also notice that it's regularly waving up and down, at equal intervals. You can also change things like speed, flow angle, and many other. All of Hell Lava Surface Shader functionalities are described in mentioned early documentation. And what about promised interaction? For now, there is none, but let's add it. Let's talk about features. Hell Lava offers a few of them. The first one is obviously interaction engine that will allow mesh surface to interact with any objects. Let me first allow to load the right lava to creator. You can easily do it by just dragging Hell Lava object to parent object field in the creator. Now, all we need to do to assign interaction engine is just pressing assign button next to the future. And that's it! Let's see now our lava in action. By just touching lava surface, we cause a reaction, manifesting itself by particles and sound. As I said before, there is more features. Let's add sink blockade to prevent too deep immersion. Also some lightning would be good. Maybe some cool effects, like projectiles and sparkles. Let's check it now. Well, lava is now much more alive. Just take a closer look to that cool hot air distortion effect. Every entity in Hell Lava have it. Sparkles are like projectiles, are spawned randomly every launch, so Hell Lava never will be the same twice. So, pretty nice, isn't it? Let's drop something to lava for fun. I'll quickly create now a sphere object that shall fall into lava. We'll see how the interaction engine will behave. And here it goes. Just let me add rigid body to that object. And we are set. Let's see what happens. Objects drop to the lava and it dives slowly as the Hell Lava adds displacement to physics objects. Here is a little better example of Hell Lava interaction engine. Lava also provides individual experience for player character. But before we get there, let's cover Hell Lava global configuration. We can set few options here, mainly two. First, Hell Lava have ability to deal damage to objects. For example, our first person controller contains script called health. We can type this script name into creator, and if we did it correctly, creator will find it and allows us to select what member is responsible for holding current player health. Let's select it. We will now see how this affects our character. Please pay attention to the current health field value as we immerse into lava. As you can see, current health is decreasing by the configured in creator value over 1 second. By default, it's 30 points at second. Also, keep in mind that change in global configuration have to be saved, otherwise they will be lost. Second option in global configuration defines something called Hull Object Recognizing System. With default configuration, lava cannot recognize if our complex monster with many colliders is one entity or not. We need to tell Hell Lava how to recognize entities. It have to be something common for every whole object, like component, layer, tag, or part of the name. In our example, let's assume that every whole entity's parent object contains health script. Let's select component and type its name. Of course, remember to save global configuration. It's worth to mention that global configuration data are saved in asset file, located in Hell Lava resource folder. You can set values manually here. Now, when we define what is whole object, we can define what is player. In Hell Lava prefabs folder, you can find prefab called player pack. Just drop it on the parent player game object. That's it, it's simply as that. Let's see how it's look in game. As you can hear and see, player is experiencing lava sound bubbling effect and flame UI effect. Okay, we are almost at the end, but there is last one thing to cover, and those are lava falls. This is the only feature that cannot be added from Creator, and this is because it is prefab drag and drop action. Just pick a place. Drag lava fall prefab. And enjoy! Lava fall will extend itself until bottom reach, so it will use minimum computer resources. As you can see, it also have its own lighting system, and also it will interact with other objects. Let me show you. And that's it! Thank you for staying with me to the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed this presentation. You can always test demo by yourself and you can download documentation. All links are in description. I hope I will hear from you again. See you around!